Hello and welcome back to Maple Farm. So just out cutting some grass at the moment whilst we wait for the corn to dry out today. We've just done the field next to the one we combined in the last video. Got that one combined since you were last with us as well. So we cut the field over to our right for hay. We've just got two to do up here for silage at the moment. Try to do the silage closest to the yard. Makes it a bit easier for us if we do. Don't worry about spreading out the silage grass, just swath it straight away. Whereas the other field was coming hay, we've obviously spread that. Some of these fields are none too smooth, unfortunately. He's pulling Jamawas here. Something different. Occasionally miss a bit in the corners when we swing around with them on the ground. Previous set from another manufacturer done the same thing. Keep a little bit of distance between ourselves and the edge. Ourselves around again. Some of the more orchid fields of grass. I do tend to move them around the rotation a bit as the fields become tired. Big John Deere on these. So what we'll do in the next couple of days is work on the grass while the cereal crops dry in the mornings, particularly the silage days. Hay is obviously a bit more weather dependent. Three rounds on there, I think, for the headlands. Also, we may struggle to turn around with the forage harvester. Evans. Soon as we're single-handed. Might look at changing our method in the future. We just can't justify the cost as the system is working at the moment. Albeit not very fast. Here makes it a bit easier. Suspension. Both track down those. Look at that. We weren't the one who drew these fields when I went across. These are certainly a lot better ground following than the predecessors. Up. It's not a small bit down the front one. Right, I'll go and get the last field done. But on that note, that's where we'll leave this video. So for now, I'll say thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you again in the next one. Goodbye for now.